indicative of the hype of Gears of War, not my bald head and beard.
It's better than no head.
Yeah, it's better. That actually is very. I'd be dead at that point. Right. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. Here is game number two between MbN and Fury. We are going to have a great matchup here. Game one, MbN, you know, they were able to go up two, then out of nowhere, it seemed like Fury just, you know, they lit up and they were able to get four straight. You know, we're going to kick it off with the veteran here, Franchise, and let's see what he's going to do. What is his approach here? Already crazes, you know, vanishing down prospect exposure. Well, the prospect hasn't taken out, and everything just fell apart immediately. Break this down for us.
Oh, yeah!
Fury kind of caught them off guard. They sent two to one side of the map, had a 2v1 situation there. Kenny Bounce made some great plays through the middle. Franchise holding blue now. So I think the strategy that they just
round here for Fury. They seem to pretty much just be on a roll. That's five in a row, five rounds in a row that they've won here. Pretty scary for MbN right now as we are going to go ahead and start things off again.
And you know, Kenny Bounce. Right, he's going towards the middle of the map. It's going to be a 2v2 situation. Guys, watch how he plays these pillars. He's not really smart. He's able to sit here and crossfire over to the middle of the map. And now they know that I just plays out of high distortion that should open up this round for them, as they're able to grab both Torpo and Frag grenades. Camille's finding himself in a 1v1 situation. He had to push forward because Soto had the boom shot. It was a desperation push. Still a 3v2, though. It's still MbN's round to win.
High distortion has that Torpo. Let's see what he's going to do with it. On the opposite side of the staircase here, so perhaps it's going to be an opportunity for him to lay down some shots, but not going to be the case because, of course, Torpo needs that charge of time. Players know when to push and when not to push. They just got to be smart. So what is Soto and the crew looking to do here as Soto's actually on the opposite of High Distortion, looking to run away from this one. And what's the game plan now?
Yeah, so Soto and Fran are still in this game in a 2v3. Now, because Soto has boom, makes it very difficult for MbN to push up on them. He still has one more rocket. They need to play this smart. They're going to have to wait for the right opportunity to move up with that power weapon, try and capitalize on a player by himself. Soto really needs to make this boom count. Because power weapons are going to respawn soon, MbN is in a position to grab the new boom shot. So Franchise is actually set up on the opposite boom.
It's going to be very dangerous here. Let's see what's going to happen. The player's actually popped out. Boom shot's going to go, and it's going to connect with High Distortion. And then he had the torque bow. Keep that in mind. So that will
Fran
be it.
Will be too.
Yeah, and now looking here, Prospect and Soto are going to be facing each other in a 1v1 now. What is going to happen as Franchise just falls? That boom shot has been taken, so now Soto has to be mindful that Prospect has a one-hit kill weapon on this, but he himself has that torque bow, so it's going to be power weapon versus power weapon.
And this has probably been the most interesting round that we can break down. Where Soto was able to get that boom kill on the server was obviously absolutely needed to happen. But what needed to happen even more than that was Fran defended the boom shot and took the kill down with him, making this a 1v1, making this a round that is winnable for his team. So we know Prospect having the boom is a little bit stronger than the Torpo here. This is still winnable as Soto has torque, and I believe I heard those rockets explode. So this may be an advantage for Soto now.
Yeah, if I'm correct, I can't tell how much he has.
Maybe shot one.
Yeah, I think it seemed like he fired one shot. Well, he only fired one, so yes. And he only has two on the chamber. I think Soto has fired one torque, I believe, and just picked up nades. So that's good. That's actually going to, that's going to give Soto an opportunity. But he needs Prospect to waste that shot. So we have a minute and 54 seconds left on the clock here. Let's see how these two players can play this one.
And what Soto's going to do is he's going to try and stay in open areas. He's not going to stay too close to the walls as the boomshot does have splash damage, so he doesn't want to get picked off by that. But if Soto ends up drawing this out, this is a win for Fury. MbN had an advantage. Prospect just picked up more boom, so this could be three rockets. So although Soto had control of the opposite side of the map, more starting to get very aggressive.
Yeah, he knows he has an opportunity here. He's actually on the hunt, so this is going to be interesting right around the corner. Soto's just actually going to get out of dodge on that one, so smart enough from him. But Prospect looking to meet him in the middle. Let's see if this is going to be the case. Pushing up right by, right past Torque. That new Torque is going to be up as well. Soto, I don't think he's located him just yet. We have a minute left on the clock now. And if he picks up that Torque, it's going to give off his location. So he's really just going to concern himself with utilizing this boom as much as he possibly can. Soto's just going to run away on the other side here. This could be the opportunity, though. He's going to miss the shot. What is going to happen here is the question. He's going to actually charge this one out. And does not get any damage. So no damage on Prospect. Has to run away. I think it was another Torque that just went out. We have 30 seconds on the clock. Pretty much playing this one. Soto's playing this one really smart. Not looking to put himself in a bad position.
Yeah, he's trying to keep a distance. What you want to do with a power weapon like a Torpo or a Sniper, you want to keep enough distance to make it so you're able to get a kill and your opponent really can't. And to keep in mind, although these players are in the game, their teammates are still just as active, scanning the security cameras, calling out where they see the opponents, when weapons are spawning up to really, you know, maximize the efficiency of the players still alive. There's a draw, so like I said, that's a win for Fury. As we saw that round really go the full time and a lot of advantages switch back and forth. Really cool round.
Yeah, so 1-0 still is the count here as we just had a draw. Let's see how it's going to play out for the next round of play. This is, again, guys, round three, but we had a draw just now. So it's going to be 1-0 on the count. Obviously, you know, win the round, survive, but now that they have boom, how do you counter that?
So, instead of running toward Torque, where it may have been a difficult situation for him to win a 1v2 anyway, he decided to play, you know, a little splitter cell there, hide behind the corner, and try and just be covert and try and get a pick. But unfortunately, it didn't work out. Yeah, so I may roll this, take it back to lobby and just see what's up.
Yeah, something's going on. I'm not quite certain. Apologies for that one, folks, as we're trying to figure out what the situation here is. It seems like Praise had ended up leaving the game on that one. So we'll go ahead and get that one sorted out in just a second. But I guess some takeaways from that, we'll find out, you know, what the score will be, if that will be just a full reset or not. But some takeaways from that one. Sanctuary definitely plays, much more of an stand. We are waiting for this matchup to start in just a second here. There you can see Mansion. So not quite certain as to why that's the case, but, you know, we'll figure that out in due time.